So once again, guys, today's the last of the day for the giveaway. So please subscribe to enter in. I got a lot going on tonight, so it'll probably be tomorrow before I let y'all know who won. This story is Harvey Organ on gold. Houston, we have a problem. Fed's yelling chicken out of an increase of interest rates. Gold skyrockets on Fed's lack of accountability. Gold advances to $1,263 in the access market. Silver to $1,562. Japan signals it may not cancel NERP as they do another U-turn. Deutsche Bank reports that it will lose money throughout 2016 unless its stock plummets on the day. More trouble in Brazil as its central bank head honcho may leave on the appointment of Lula insurance giant Minuto Rey purchases gold and states it because of negative interest rates. Peabody, largest USA coal miner, misses interest rate payment and may declare bankruptcy. China and Kazakhstan wish to increase cooperation in developing a physical market for gold, which I just read that story. Gold, $1,229.3, down $1.10 at the COMEX closing time. Silver, $1,521, down 5 cents. In the access markets at 515, gold was $1,262 and silver was $1,562. In the words of Bill Murphy of GATA, today on remarking on gold's huge advance in the access market, Houston, we have a problem. The Fed's credibility has now been shot. Yellen backs away from increasing rates to global disturbances. At the gold COMEX today, we had a poor delivery day, registering zero notices for nil ounces. And for silver, we had 230 notices for 1,150,000 ounces for the active March delivery month. Several months ago, COMEX had 303 tons of total gold. Today, the total inventory rests at 211.33 tons for a loss of 92 tons over that period. In silver, the open interest fell by 2,055 contracts down to 166,180, with silver down by 9 cents yesterday in ounces. The OI is still represented by 0.831 billion ounces, or 119% of annual global silver production, excluding Russia and China. In silver, we had 230 notices served upon for 1,150,000 ounces. Excuse me, I'll spit it out soon enough. In gold, total COMEX gold fell by 6,624 contracts to 493,086 contracts as the price of gold was down $14 with yesterday's trading at COMEX closing. The fall in OI gold should relieve a little pressure on our bankers. We had another big change in gold inventory at the GLD, a deposit of 2.09 tons. Thus, the inventory rests tonight at 792.23 tons. The appetite for gold coming from gold from China is depleting, not only from the LBMA and GLD, but also the COMEX is bleeding the gold. Our 670 tons of rock bottom inventory in GLD and gold has been broken. It looks to me that China has taken the last amounts of physical gold from the GLD. I guess only the place left for China to receive physical gold after they deplete the GLD will be the FRBNY and the COMEX. In silver, we had no changes in inventory, and thus the inventory rests at 325,868,000 ounces. First, here's an outline of what will be discussed tonight. Today, we had open interest in silver fell by 2,055 contracts down to 166,180 as the price of silver was down 26 cents with yesterday's trading. The total OI for gold fell by 6,624 contracts to 493,086 contracts, as gold was down $14 in price from yesterday's level. Let's see, Asian affairs. Tuesday night, Wednesday morning, Shanghai closed up by 6.11 points or 0.21%. Hang Seng closed down by 3.017 points or 0.15%. The Nikkei closed down by 1.42.62 or 0.83%. Australia's All Ordinaries was up 0.15%. The Chinese Yuan onshore closed down at 6.52. Oil rose to $37.12 per barrel for WTI and $39.38 for Brent. Stocks in Europe so far all mixed. Offshore yuan trades at 6.52118 yuan to the dollar versus 6.5200. So, I guess that's all we really need. This is mostly oil markets and other bullshit. So, that's all we really need to read about that. So, remember, subscribe to enter into the gold giveaway, the silver giveaway. It's going to end tonight at midnight. So, subscribe. Please subscribe. Enter into the giveaway. Thanks a lot, guys. Take care.